In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a huge range of amazing simulations really quickly just using the soft body simulation. You'll learn how to create a necklace rig, swinging signs, dynamic cables, literally anything you want to add overlapping motion to, and, well, anything else you can think of. They all use exactly the same workflow, and I'm going to walk you through every step. Okay, so first, I'll show you how to create a dynamic cable, chain, rope, literally whatever design you want. We'll then work out how to collide it. Then later, I'll show you how we can easily add hanging objects, which you can even use without any cable, still using a soft body simulation. For this tutorial, I'll be demonstrating everything you need while creating this necklace rig, as this is a more complex combination of all the techniques required, but I'll be showing everything you need to apply these methods to any of your own animations. Stage 1. Create your mesh. Here is where you create the design for your cable, chain, rope, whatever you need. We'll create a small repeatable part that will use an array modifier, so we can change the length later, and you can reuse it over and over for different lengths. For our chain, I added a torus with low subdivisions, beveled the center loop so I can move half to create our link, then duplicate this mesh, rotate it, and move it to create our base shape, leaving enough room for another link. You can select all, hit Alt-S to scale the thickness. For cables, you could just use a cylinder with an extruded loop for extra detail. This mesh can look however you want, as long as it has plenty of loop cuts so it can curve. We want to move the origin to the center end point of the mesh so it scales from the same point. Move the 3D cursor here and set the origin to the 3D cursor. If you change your mesh, remember to move the origin to this point. Let's center it at the world origin too. Now add an array modifier, changing the relative offset value in the correct axis to link the chains. Increase the count number and we have our chain. Stage 2, soft body mesh. I'll explain in a moment how we use this, but we need to add a cube that we want to scale to fit around our chain. In the object properties viewport display, I click display as wire so we can still see the chain and turn off the render visibility. I move it to the origin point of the chain so it's central and roughly resize the mesh. Now we also want to put the origin at the center end of the mesh, then snap the object to the same origin as the chain. Now both scale from the same point. So the way this works is we add a soft body simulation to the outer mesh and with the right settings we can make the physics of it move in a certain way, in this case a chain. Then we use a surface deform modifier on the chain which deforms it with the soft body mesh. And so when the soft body mesh isn't visible it looks like a real chain. This can then interact with collision objects realistically too. So we need to add loop cuts to the soft body mesh to allow it to bend. Now you need to consider how you want your simulation to move. These sims have the same settings but a different number of loop cuts. More loop cuts can make the sim more flexible and bouncy, and fewer makes it appear more solid and smooth. For a necklace, I'm happy using about 100 loop cuts as chains can move in a more flexible way. But things like cables, especially bigger ones, are heavier and move more as one, so require fewer loop cuts. So finally, let's scale down both parts as it's currently huge and apply scale. I'll name the chain, and from now on we'll refer to this outer mesh as the soft body mesh. Stage 3, adding shape. The awesome thing about this method is we can choose any starter shape, and it's all still very adjustable at this stage. I'll be creating a loop, but you can create any starter shape you need with this method. First, I'll create a Bezier circle, then select the soft body mesh and add a curve modifier. Select the curve object to be the Bezier circle. If needed, change the deform axis until the mesh is following the circle. Do exactly the same for the chain mesh on the same circle. Now we have complete flexibility. If you scale either mesh, they now expand around the curve. You can still add more links with the array modifier, and we can adjust the Bezier to any shape. You can change the chain or cable size by scaling the chain, then adding or reducing the array count. You can scale the soft body mesh to fit closer to the chain by pressing S, then Shift X, Y, or Z, whichever axis the original mesh sat along. To create other shapes, you can instead use the Bezier curve, and all of the adjustments work the same. Create giant swooping cables, small hanging elements, anything you need. For cables that are maintaining their rough shape, often for more decorative purposes, you can put them at the starting shape straight away. However, if you're looking for more complex movements where the ends move a lot, if you start with a curve, that curve can remain in the mesh when you try to pull it straight. So here, try to start with a straighter starting position and then animate the ends into the start position you want. Then the cables work very dynamically. This is where we create our final shape that the simulation starts from, so we can position it in with whatever characters, buildings, or objects it goes with. I'm going to create this necklace demo using this Mixamo character. For a character, make sure it's in its default pose. This will help us later on. Move the chain around the character, and here we can scale it all at once. If everything's selected, adjust the position and scale of the necklace, and start to adjust the individual points of the curve to put the necklace in a more natural starting position. I'm scaling the front point where we can later hang a pendant, and scaling the back to fit evenly across the neck. Two main points to consider when shaping your mesh. First, you need to work out where you want to pin your simulation and make sure you move that point to the right spot relative to what they're connected to, as they won't be moving from here. This can be at one point or multiple. For a necklace on a character, you want somewhere on the back of the neck. This is needed to stop the necklace from flying everywhere. Choose a point that follows the natural curve of where a necklace would sit, and position the necklace to this point. Second, you want there to be a gap between the soft body mesh and whatever it's colliding with to prevent collision problems, including where it's pinned. So for the character, I've left this gap all the way around, and on other sims you can use non-collision objects to cover up any joins. You can also press Ctrl T on a point to rotate the point so the mesh follows the shape of the character to make sure it sits right. Adjust the shape and scale of your mesh until you're happy. We'll soon start applying modifiers where this shape is locked in. Feel free to duplicate this setup ready for use on something else, or to easily try again if something goes wrong. For a loop, make sure it rejoins itself, in this case making sure the chain links line up. To make the soft body mesh loop, in edit mode delete the two end faces. Scale it so the two ends meet up. I leave a small gap so it's still visible, and we'll be joining these after applying the modifiers. Scale the mesh so it sits on the edges of the chain mesh. And finally, apply the scale of the chain and soft body meshes. Now let's apply the modifiers. For the chain, apply the array modifier, then the curve modifier. For the soft body mesh, apply the curve modifier. Now these are proper meshes shaped in this way. Find where the soft body mesh looped and merge each vertice pair at center. Finally, I make sure the origins of the chain and soft body mesh are on the same spot as the Bezier curve origin, using the 3D cursor. We can hide the Bezier curve and we are now ready to start simulating. Stage 4, simulation. Let's hide everything except the soft body mesh and add a soft body simulation to it. Press play and it just bounces, as we need to choose the vertices for it to hang from. In edit mode, create a new vertex group called pin group. Select all vertices you want the sim to hang from. Here we choose a point at the back of the neck and press assign to put them in the pin vertex group. In soft body settings for the goal vertex group, select pin. Increase the strength value to 1 so it fully attaches and we have a hanging mesh. As the sims get more complex, use the cache settings to choose your frame range and bake the simulation so you can view it in real time. Then to make changes, delete the bake, adjust the settings and bake again. Next we need to be able to actually attach the pin points to objects so they follow the motion. We do this using empties. Select the pin vertices, hit Ctrl-H, hook to new object. If you have multiple places you want it to be held that move independently, create a new hook object for the pin vertices at each of these points. Now, very important, select the softbody mesh and move any new hook modifiers above the softbody sim in the modifier stack, or you'll get some interesting results. Now if we animate this empty and bake the simulation, it follows this point. So by parenting this empty to a moving object, the simulation moves with it. But first, let's change a few settings to make this more realistic. To stop the mesh from collapsing, under edges, move the bending slider above 0. The higher the number, the stronger the structure. I go for 2. Now it keeps its shape. Now changing the springiness, under goal, I increase the stiffness setting to full. This damping setting can also be very useful. It goes up to 50. Higher numbers reduce the spring effect and bring the movement to a stop quicker. Here I put it to 8, but you just need to experiment to find what works for your sim. If the soft body is likely to collide with itself like it does here, then turn on self-collision. Now we have a more natural looking simulation. We can adjust these settings further at any time.
If your simulation is meant to be less flexible, ticking the stiffness setting can also work really well.
Next, we can create the collision objects. Here, I'll unhide the character and add collision physics properties. Add this to any object you want your sim to interact with. I reduce the outer margin quite low to make sure it fits in the gap under the necklace. You want the inner margin as low as possible, which speeds up baking time, but if objects are colliding quickly with larger movements, if the margin is too thin, the sim can go straight through the collision object as it isn't detected. The bigger the action, increase the inner margin, but understand this will increase baking time. A setting to also be aware of is this damping slider, which affects how bouncy the collision surface is, which you can change any time for what looks best for your simulations. I'm going to increase it to 1 so the chain just sits. I can turn off self-collision as the necklace won't really collide with itself here. Now with the collision sorted, bake the softbody sim and we can start to see how it interacts with our character. We'll refine the sim settings later on when we add animation, but for now, the fun part. Stage 5, connecting the mesh. Now we can add our chain or cable mesh. Make the chain mesh visible, and because we lined up everything perfectly earlier on, all we have to do is on the chain mesh, add a surface to form modifier. Select the soft body mesh as the target, and click bind. Now if we turn off overlays, it looks like the chain is being simulated. This is because it deforms perfectly inside the soft body mesh, and our sims now look like a part of the scene. Stage 6, animation. Now we can create some movement for the simulation to interact with. We just need to parent the pin empty to whatever the sim is meant to move with. If it's a solid object, just select the empty, then the object, Ctrl-P and parent it and it's good to go. For a deforming mesh like our character, select the empty, shift-select the character, tab into edit mode, select the nearest three vertices, Ctrl-P, make vertex parent. For a character, I set up the necklace in the default pose where it only needs to be done once. Then, any animation keyframes are moved further along the timeline, so the character transitions from the default pose to the action start frame, allowing the soft body sim to settle naturally first before running through the action. These animation keyframes can be swapped to anything, all starting from the same point. We then change the timeline range to only render the parts we want. Just to show how I set this up, import a Mixamo character with an animation, select all bones, move the keyframes along the timeline, at frame 1 hit Alt, S, G and R, and add Lockrot scale keyframes. And it's ready. So as you can now see, the empty moves with the character. So if we bake the sim, the necklace also moves with the character while staying pinned in place. This is where your own creative freedom comes in, by changing the soft body or collision settings to get the look you want. Even changing the field weights can experiment with effects like zero gravity. Each different situation will likely require unique settings. It's often just trial and error until you find something you like. A final setting to be aware of is the soft body solver settings, which changes the accuracy of the simulation. As mentioned earlier, large movements increase the chance of missing collisions, so you can increase the collision inner thickness, but you can also increase the soft body solver settings. Blender specifically says for the step size minimum, increase this value if the soft body misses fast moving collision objects, so just increasing this range can help, but do anticipate longer bake times. Stage 7, overlapping action. Now here's a really easy way to add what's known in animation as overlapping action. This is where an action can drag behind and follow through after the main motion. The soft body sim is actually already an example of this, but we can go a level further by adding hanging elements like a pendant or a sign, or really anything you can think of that might swing behind the main motion, and it's all part of the same simulation. Here we'll add a pendant to the necklace. First, let's unbind the chain as we're changing the soft body mesh. Select a face where you'd like an object to pivot, or adjust the mesh to create a new one. Choose a side that will face mostly downwards in the simulation. Extrude this face. We need it longer than a pendant would be. Then, create several loop cuts. Remember, the number of loop cuts you add can affect the motion. Now rebind the chain. It looks interesting, but stick with it. We want to place two empties on this mesh. By using the 3D cursor, place an empty on the first edge loop and the last edge loop. Parent these to the mesh like we did with the pin empty, shift selecting the empty, then the mesh. Select three vertices and Control P, make vertex parent. Do this for both empties and they'll follow the simulation. Now we create a placeholder pendant. Add a cube and squash it. Set the origin to the center top and snap this to the first empty. Now it's just two simple steps. We want to parent the pendant to the top empty, then add a damped track constraint to the pendant, selecting the bottom empty and finding the right axis that points towards it. Now playing the animation, the pendant inherits the individual motion of the soft body extrusion, moving slightly behind the rest of the necklace. You can also simulate the mass of any hanging elements using this mass control point setting on the soft body mesh, by creating a new vertex group called mass and assigning all the vertices to it, and selecting this group as the control point. You can now adjust the mass of different parts of the mesh depending on their weight value. So by adding a weight value of something like 0.7 to the rear vertices, and creating a gradient of values increasing the further forward it goes, with 1 at the very front, this can simulate like the pendant is actually pulling on the chain. The overlapping action is only minimal in this setup, but the exact same setup works really well for all sorts of swinging elements you may need. You can even use it without a chain or cable for a solid moving object like a hanging lamp, following the same process as the pendant, this time just following a simple vertical soft body sim. It's useful to remember that adding hanging elements using these techniques is not indestructible, as we sort of fake the motion using constraints. The more complex the motion, especially moving upside down and twisting, it can cause problems. This is just a method to quickly create overlapping action within the same simulation to create even more visual interest. Now to add your own pendant. Create whatever you need and place the origin in some kind of loop at the top. Move it to the same origin and parent it to the constraint pendant. Add some other kind of mesh design that links the chain and the pendant loop. Parent that to the soft body vertices it sits on top of using make vertex parent by shift selecting the object, then the soft body mesh. In edit mode, navigate your way to selecting three soft body mesh points, Control P, and you're there. Hide the placeholder pendant, and playing the simulation, you have your very own necklace. If you need even more accuracy, the main pendant is separate so it can be keyframed to fix any problems for uses like close-up shots or more complex motion. Now you have a very versatile rig, as the only place it connects is using the pin empties, so simply unparent it from one object and reparent it to another to change what you use it on, which could be very useful for efficiency by reusing assets. I hope this video has given you some new ideas and workflows for your own projects. I really appreciate you being here. Comment what tutorial you want me to make next. Subscribe for more. Goodbye.